just had a Facebook message from Fiona. Hi, Silver. I've just fixed my tapered ace plaster boards through the walls. What is the best method of finishing these? Well, Fiona, I'd recommend taping and jointing. There's several processes, so I'll show you how to do it now. We're now going to demonstrate taping and jointing, which is a method of finishing the plasterboard surface. For this, you will need some specialist tools. A 4-inch and a 6-inch jointing knives. Now, they may look like paper scrapers, which we're all used to using, but these are very flexible and much thinner. A trowel, we generally use a stainless steel trowel, but any trowel will actually do the job. Another specialist tool is what we call the internal angle tool, and this I will demonstrate in a few minutes when we come on to do the taping and jointing. We use a paper tape on the joints. This is actually stronger, and it is the Cyniac recommendation. Comes on a 150 meter roll, which we would actually cut to length. I'm going to need two. So once I've measured one, I can actually use the roll and the one I've already cut. And I can use this process whether I need one, two, or 22. Paper tape has a natural crease line. So to do the internal corner, that makes it very easy, because I can simply fold and crease, and that will now form in the internal corner. The compound, from a mixing point of view, if you haven't seen our earlier videos, you can actually look back and you can see how we actually mix the compounds. We can either use a handboard or hawk, as its name, or for taping and jointing, we can actually use a trowel for a very similar process. What I need to do is actually apply the compound to the board surface. So again, using the back of my trowel and the 4-inch knife, I can then run the compound in the internal corner. As you become more experienced, you can then actually use the trowel. Take your paper tape and place neatly into the corner, just using your finger just to make sure it's located properly. What we now need to do is secure the tape into the compound. If you actually place your knife on and gently push up on either side of the paper tape, that will secure that paper tape in place. So it's not going to slide now as I actually pull down. Pushing the paper tape into the compound. As you get closer to the bottom, what you need to do is, again, just gently push so as not to tear the paper. So the tape is now bedded into the compound. But what I need to do is cover the face. And again, using the 4-inch knife, what we're actually doing, covering the face. This is where we use now the internal angle tool. Because we've got two wet edges, obviously I've not got a nice, clean, sharp internal corner. What this will do is finish both edges at the same time, giving me a nice, sharp, clean internal corner. Straight joints, very similar. What we need to do is apply our compound between the two tapers of the plasterboard. Probably see now a lot clearer when we mean by the two tapers, because it's actually the compound is actually filling out to the two edges. So now our joint is actually filled between the two tapers. We can now bed our paper tape into the compound. And the easiest way to do that is place over the centre, just gently pushing it into the compound, and then using your thumb and fingers, you can actually keep it nice and straight, and your thumb is just putting a little bit of pressure on just to push the paper tape into the compound. Similar to what we did on the internal angle, what we need to do is to prevent that paper tape from sliding. So what we need to do is, again, just gently push the compound out at the top. That paper tape now is now secure. Putting the finger on the back of the jointing knife will create that little bit of pressure because of the flex that we told you about earlier. And you can now see that it's bedding it into the compound. The excess compound is just in front on the paper. As we get to the bottom, again, because of the shape of the knife, etc., what we can do is just gently push out at the bottom. What we need to do now is cover the paper tape. So we're actually bedding the tape with the compound between the two tapers. And that's your paper tape bedded onto your surface of your plasterboard. So that's the first process in taping and jointing. Once the material has set and dried a little, what we can do now is apply the filling coat. For the straight joints, we will still use our trowel, and the filler coat will finish approximately 50 millimeters either side of the joint as we see it now. For the internal corner, we will actually use our 6-inch jointing knife as opposed to the 4-inch. So we're actually overlapping our existing coat. We'll also use, again, the internal corner trowel, which you saw me demonstrate when we actually bedded our tapes. Straight joint first. We have a compound, which is a joint cement. So if you place the compound roughly in the center of your trowel, and then at an angle of about 45 degrees, you actually drag the trowel up, forcing the material either side of the joint. You will create what we call a raised edge. So that is actually proud of the plasterboard. What we need to do is take that edge out. You can do that, as you can see, using the knife. Again, if you're not confident, what you could do is allow it to dry, and before you apply the final coat, you could actually sand that out. So we need to take those edges off. And then finally, swing your trowel from the ceiling down and from the floor up. Internals, 6-inch knife. Place your material onto your knife, into the corner, and run down your internal angle. So you are overlapping your bedding coat. Again, any raised edges. For those of you who have got a bit more confidence, you can take those out and then simply run the knife down from the top to the bottom. This gives us a nice clean edge. And what we need to do is repeat that on the opposite edge. The tool that we demonstrated when we bedded the tapes, we now fill in. We can actually run down to give us a nice, clean, sharp internal angle. Any small imperfections, edges, you can gently remove those. Internal corners, we two coat. Straight joints, we will actually three coat. But before we apply the final coat to the straight joints, it is advisable to remove any small imperfections that you might have at this stage. And that is done by using either a pole sander, hence it's on a pole, or we could use a hand sander. We're only going to do a small amount of sanding, but obviously I still need to put on my dust mask. Now, using the pole sander on the edge, and then simply straight down the center of the joint. And that would be enough at this stage. We can now apply our third and final coat. Using the trowel and the joint cement. And again, we want to be approximately the width of the trowel. And again, because of the trowel lines or the edges, we can actually remove them using the jointing knife, or you can do it by using the trowel. By removing them at this stage, it means we've got less sanding to do later. So the final coat has been applied to the straight joints. Internal corners is a two-coat process. The joints are now complete. Before we can seal the surface, we need to sand the joints so that they are nice and flat to the board surface. You can see here, there is actually a mark in the joint which needs to be sanded out prior to sealing the surface. If you have got any small areas that just need touching up, instead of using the pole sander, we can actually use the hand sander. That is now perfectly flush with the face of the board and ready for sealing. The sealer coat is applied neat, unlike a mist coat, which is watered down emulsion. The purpose of the sealer coat is it seals the surface because the paint will dry different on the face of the board than it will on the face of the joint. And what happens is you get a colour differentiation between the two surfaces, and it looks as though, and you can actually see the joints, but the surface is perfectly flat. It's all due down to the difference in suction between the two surfaces. So if you don't seal, it's known in the trade as Regency striping. You will see these stripes, but it's perfectly flat. It can be applied by brush or by roller, and we simply apply over the whole surface, board and joint. So, once the surface has been completely sealed, it should be allowed to dry before we apply the mist and two coats of emulsion to give the wall its final finish. If you'd like to challenge silver, please get in touch by email or on our Facebook page.